It is Rock Tales Live at 5. And we have another very special guest joining us here at the Rockin' Roundtable. Friend of the show, friend in real life, a handsome man extraordinaire, Tom DeSavia, New York Times best-selling author, bon vivant, a music industry veteran, musician yourself, but more specifically...
Not right? a musician.
No, just go with it.
Oh, I mean, totally accomplished.
Uh-huh, exactly. Go with this. A musician in the sense that I hear your lovers say that you're a songbird in the sack.
Well, I do have dulcet tones.
That's what I hear.
But yeah, those who can't, A&R is sort of the role.
So wait, is that the gift? The only way that you know how to pick, because you're in A&R. You're yes. an A&R man.
Yeah.
So do you have to be really good in the sack
apparently
to
not.
Be able to be able to pick great bands?
Yeah, apparently not. No. No.
No?
No, it's look, I've been...
Maybe I'm feeling kind of extra lovey-dovey because we got Mariah in the background. Right?
That's who it is. Oh, a Rock and Roll Hall of Fame nominee.
I mean, right? that's... Yeah. We're going to go deep today. I mean,
did
Tom,
you discover her?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Little known fact.
At a punk rock club
yes.
in Reseda? Yeah.
Yes.
You, by the way...
I'm a mess.
You look...
I don't even know what the hell's happening.
You kind of look... the most you've ever looked like Wolverine.
Can I take my jacket off?
Oh, please do. Look at that rad shirt, by the way. I mean, you're upstaging Brando in the cool rock shirt category today.
Up yours, Brando.
Yeah, Brando's got his Husker Du. You have the Idols. What does it say?
It says, "Are for Lovers."
And you love this band, correct?
I am a super fucking fanboy for this band. Okay. I don't work with them.
Okay.
I've never met them. Mm-hmm. I've seen them live a few times, and I am full-on fanboy. I think they're one of the best bands of this century.
Are they playing wow. anytime? I've never seen them play, so...
They are. They're going to be playing two nights at the Palladium in May, and I'm going mm-hmm. both nights. They're there.
And they're nominated in the Rock Hall, you were saying.
Then they're, yes, they're yeah. the... No, this is the track they do with LCD Sound System. They're just fucking great.
Hold the phone, hit the head, it's a cheat. Push me away like I'm Lucifer, so to speak. My focus is
push me away like I'm Lucifer, so to speak. What a fucking great line.
They're just I think they're fantastic. That, a Welsh band. Band from Wales.
Would you
yeah.
tell the people mm-hmm. listening here on YouTube, watching yeah. on YouTube, who you just saw the other night at the Belasco Theater
oh.
in Los Angeles, California?
Okoboke Beaver.
I'm sorry,
holy
what?
Holy shit.
I'm sorry?
Okoboke Beaver.
Okoboke Beaver? I mean, I love saying it. It feels so good.
Say it one more time.
Okoboke Beaver. Feels so good coming out.
Right? It feels really good. So they're a buddy of mine that I used to work with at Elektra a million years ago, now lives in Japan, and he was telling me, he's like, there's this Japanese like punk hardcore band, all girl.
Okoboke Beaver.
All girl.
All girl. Melted drummer, insane.
It's like punk rock Pizzicato 5.
They were insane. And I went because I trust my friend and I watched a couple of videos and they just did and it was sold out. It was packed out.
Like, oh, awesome.
And it was, but they did just a Ramon set. It was exactly an hour nonstop.
Oh, Tricky Dicky's really.
Just
he's a good A&R man, but he does not know how to use a mic.
Yeah, no. I'm on the other side of the desk. They were just fucking mind blown. I thought they were great. And it was literally like an hour, 50 songs in an hour that were 35 seconds each.
Awesome.
And just really fun.
I had a friend reach out to me like 2 months ago and he's like, you need to have Okoboke Beaver on Rock Tales.
Really?
So I had this vision of having them right there, but it's too late. They're too big because they were going to, I think they were going to play at some tiny house like in Glassell Park or something, but they blew up so big.
I had no idea. Like I went because my friend
was awesome. Great.
And it was really fun. Really fun. Just pure punk rock show.
Because we dove right in.
Yeah.
Okay. Again, I want to really tell everyone how important
Tom is as a friend of the show. You've been on multiple times. Mm-hmm. You know, our intention today is, you know, I think Brando, you have a, you were excited that Tom's coming on, not just because we're going to get into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and talk about all the nominees, and this is my first time actually seeing an official Rock Hall ballot, right? So we'll, let's show our viewers.
You're not showing it there.
We'll do it later on, but like it'll be fun to kind of know like how this all goes down, and you know, we'll talk about how long you've been a voting member of the Rock Hall. My goal is to get you drunk enough to basically secure our vote, and maybe we'll be aligned, but like I want to try to brainwash you into picking who we want this year,
because
maybe we're going to disagree. I hope we're all on the same page, and if we do disagree, I'm going to keep giving you booze until you figure out that we're right and you're wrong.
There's going to be some disagreements.
Oh, Jesus.
There's going to be some disagreements. I was talking to Richard about this because, as shameful as this is to admit it, this table specifically, I missed metal. I missed it. When I was a kid.
No, it's still here.
No, but I saw what was on the MTV shows and the ones that were hits.
Confused. It's still here. Very confused.
I liked punk rock. And at that point, there was a line in the sand. And you had to pick a team.
Yeah.
And I didn't like all the big hairspray stuff.
You picked team punk rock?
And I picked team punk rock.
And he's picking team punk rock from the San Fernando Valley.
From the 818.
He had every opportunity to go over the hill onto Sunset Boulevard.
Oh, to FM the station, bro.
Yes. Filthy McNasties. And so I'd be taken to punk rock shows every once, or rock and roll shows every once in a while, and I'd just be like, eh. And now in retrospect, it was literally, I was maybe, I don't know, 28 when someone said something about Iron Maiden. I like, never really heard of it. And played me an Iron Maiden record, and my head exploded. And I'm like, holy shit, I saw so
many. Is this you admitting that you're dumb?
It's time for Maiden Vicious and Tom DeSavia admitting live on Rock Tales that he picked Team Punk Rock and he regrets it.
I don't regret it.
Even though he is a New York Times commercial author celebrating punk rock, it's official. Metal still rules, takes the cake. Is that what you're here to admit to the world, Tom?
In a way.
Cool.
No, but it was funny. I literally didn't, like when I heard Iron Maiden for the first time, I thought all metal sounded like...
Don't you fucking insult Rat, Cinderella, any of those fucking bands right now.
Because
I will fucking come across the table at you.
All metal sounded like
G-Core rock with hairspray. And I was like, you know, and it was like, and it was all like...
No, give me a fucking band. Give me a band. You're on thin ice. Give me a band that you think all metal sounded like. Name a band.
Poison.
Okay, that's...
Yeah. But you saw Poison.
And I saw Poison.
Back in the day.
Back in the country club took me, and everyone looked like my mom's friend, like with too much makeup on and smelled like Aquanet.
Yeah.
And there was a lot of lace.
Yeah.
And I remember, and I was just like...
And what were you wearing?
Oh, probably, you know, like a t-shirt and jeans, something truly
punk
rock. So
you felt insecure.
Oh, I felt totally insecure.
Because you're like, are people going to see my nipples if I look like Brett right now?
Well, no, I'd actually cut my nipples out so people could see my nipples. Come on,
because you're a songbird in the sack. Everyone knows it.
But yeah, and so I just didn't pay attention to it. And there was so much, and I got deep into the knockoffs or the side roads of punk rock. So I was big into what was called cowpunk back then.
Yeah.
Now called
Americana. Like the Longriders and...
Longriders, Lone Justice. Uh-huh, I was obsessed with Rank and File.
But Lone Justice is not punk rock. There's no fucking way.
But they played in the clubs adjacent. Of Los Angeles.
Well, Lone Justice, by the way, is one of my all-time favorites. Maria McKee, her voice.
There's a new record coming out.
Oh.
It's but of old stuff. I don't know if I'm allowed to say that.
No.
This just in!
There's a record coming out of a variety of tracks
over
the years.
Will you play, what's the song? I love the sound of your wheels. Oh, Wheels? Is that what
Wheels.
It is?
Wheels.
Will you play that? I love that track.
And there's a...
Oh, wait, just hold on a second. Do you want to hold me?
No, we're going to...
Oh, my gosh. Prayer Circle?
Prayer Circle.
Okay. Listen to this, guys. Hold on just a moment. Just wait till her voice comes in. Oh, fuck, it's so good. And then the low vocals on, yeah.
Did Dweezil ever go out with Maria McKee?
Shh.
Are you going to sway with us or not?
Yeah. So good.
Yeah. You're going the wrong way.
I am.
It's like, I know, wait. I'm sorry. The A&R guy doesn't have rhythm. You know that. It's like,
oh my God, what a fucking.
But they play the Palomino all the time. Yeah. And it was, I started singing them when I was like 15. Mm-hmm. And that was the first scene I fell into. I liked all the punk rock stuff, but it terrified me because I didn't fit in. I always felt like a kind of a victim at a punk rock show. I felt like a rag doll.
Sorry about that, Tom.
Yeah. It was hard. I'm glad to finally talk about it.
Where else do you feel out of place, Tom?
Well, at this table right now, pretty much. And it was all that stuff, and then it was something called the Paisley Underground, which was Bangles, Long
Green
Riders,
on Red.
Green on Red.
I just have
to say, right, your disclaimer of, you know, punk rock adjacent.
Yeah.
So you're saying top 40 music is punk rock adjacent? Because wasn't this the equivalent of Lone Justice was kind of mainstream? No. They came out.
No one played it.
No, Lone
Justice. No one played it.
It wasn't like they were trying to be.
Lone
like,
Justice had
everyone
one
Everyone was trying to be.
Can
every
I,
punk
can I brand
band, every
explain
metal
the punk
band.
Rock scene in the early 80s to Ahmed Zappa?
By the way, that's Lilith Fair right
Wait,
there.
You're talking non-top 40 like Rat? Is that what you're saying?
How
When was the
you
last time you listened
Rat?
To Crazy Train? I was talking to someone the other day. It's amazing guitar solos and a monkey song. All for it. It's a pop tune.
Okay, hold on a second. There's so many things happening right now. So many things I want to...
I'm talking to the wrong listener audience out there.
There's so many punches I want to throw at you in the fucking mosh pit right now. That's how I feel because of the things that you're saying. There's so many elbows and punches. But let's...
I can wrap this all up in one thing because people should know before we get into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame ballot that Tom has a fantastic book out there in the world.
Yeah, you call it paperback
More
now.
More Fun.
Wait, hold on. It's paperback edition. That means you had to sell so many.
We have two.
That's fucking congratulations. It's
Thank
it's
you.
So I cannot stress this enough. The hardback comes out and you hope that you get through those to get to the paperback edition. It's hard to sell a bunch of books out there, and you guys have consistently crushed it. These books are amazing. Really, really, really. We went to, I want you to tell your story, but we actually went to an event celebrating this, and we were talking about that a little earlier.
At Largo.
Yeah, and Paul Rubens was there. It was one of the last things we all attended with Paul. So, you know, Paul, I know this is your favorite
right
show
in
heaven.
Tony Hawk was at that event. He was on that one.
It was
He's
awesome.
In this book. Yeah.
Yeah, so Tom's book, just for people at home who see this book and should go buy it.
Yep.
That it really chronicles an amazing era in Los Angeles.
Mm-hmm.
Late
70s,
early
80s. That you're obsessed with.
What's that?
That you coming to LA were obsessed with.
Okay, here's my story. So obsessed with that recently, as you know, the way I like to relax, Tom, at night is to make very elaborate playlists on Spotify.
But he likes to get high, piss into his own mouth, and dream of ancho chilies.
Exactly. take a couple gummies
Cast
and
the
sit
first
there
stone
and make a play.
Zappa.
So I watched a recent documentary about the punk rock scene at Madame Wong's and the Hong Kong Cafe in Chinatown.
Yeah. On PBS.
Circa 78, 79, 80, 81.
Yep.
And the Cafe de Grand in Hollywood. And so I just started making a playlist inspired by that documentary, and I used that book as a resource to cross-reference, because he's got all of that in the book. And so if you just look up Madame Wong's in that book, all the punk rockers have stories of, I went to see so-and-so at Madame Wong's. I was there the night that Alice Bagg did this at Madame Wong's. I at the Hong Kong Cafe wouldn't let my band play. It's all in that book. And so I used the book to just make sure that the music that I put on the playlist was qualified.
I'm sorry, the music that you put?
I just, what happened?
Did you, what was that?
I don't know. I think I just had a stroke. I think I just had a mini stroke. But anyway, I just made sure that the music that I had on the list was cross-referenced in that book.
I should make a disclaimer.
Yeah.
So the thing I'm really proud of, both books... turned profitable.
Yeah.
Now that means we made
$100 million. Be real. $100 million.
$100. But no one in this world, past, present, or future, wants to buy a punk rock book by this, shockingly enough.
That's not true.
So I am the oats, as it were, to John Doe.
Are you suing John?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. We'll see him in court. Yeah. So John Doe, I bugged him for 20 years to write a book.
Yep.
He said, no, for years. Finally settled on an oral history, so it wasn't just the X story. So yeah. It was the whole scene. And he threw down, he's like, I'll do it if you do it with me. So I walked into the luckiest scene of anybody.
Let me say it back to you.
Go.
Okay. You had the tenacity and the idea to say, you got to do this. You got to do this, right?
I'm the star.
You're the star.
John is holding me back. I've never put it together.
No, I didn't say that.
Yeah.
John is not your peer. Yeah. He's your lesser.
Right.
Wow.
I've never.
Okay. Cool.
Doe, if you're watching, I will see you in court.
Yeah. Doe, if you're watching, we'd love to have you right here on Rock Tales.
Oh, by the way, we should do a punk rock. Can you curate like a punk rock night here where we just get like a all-star jam of who's who just to come play some tracks and we'll talk about it? And
yeah, if we could bring Pleasant Gaiman, who is the utmost authority and my favorite.
We can get Pleasant on here.
Punk rock friend from this experience. She's incredible. Yeah.
As long as there's
my neighbor.
As long as
and your neighbor.
Buckets in the corner in case people are doing weird shit. They just keep it clean. keep it clean, cat, and classy. Throw
buckets
up in the bucket.
It's an amazing book. Yeah. People should get it. I love this book so much. And it was so helpful to me to make a great playlist.
So lots of things have been happening on the show. I want to just fill you in. So in the last couple of weeks, we've had some really fun experiences that I want you to feel jealous of. All right? Because all of these things are also punk rock adjacent, and I think you'll agree that the that Robert Schwartzman from the band Rooney is punk rock adjacent, and he is. We talked about one of the movies that his father made that he's now working with. I just want to mention to you, and I would like to invite you to be a guest to come hang with us, because we were going to go to the official Rad Day. Right? It is coming up. And this, by the way, this is a fun event. March 21st is the official Rad Day. We're going to celebrate Rad Day with a screening of Rad in theaters March 21st. The only time for this new, updated, high-res edition soundtrack, all kind of
it's
fixed.
Rad.
It's Rad.
It's Rad.
Oh, the
Rad.
Hell yeah. Rad. Yes.
Punk rock adjacent.
In.
BMX,
in.
Whole thing.
Well, I was going to say, I haven't seen him in years. I think I met him through Richard.
Yeah.
But I love Schwartzman.
Oh, he's
what
the,
a great guy. I haven't seen him since all the unpleasantness of the world. But I just adore him.
Since the time you realized that metal is better?
Yes, exactly.
Is that what you mean by that the unpleasantness?
It was when I finally let Lixaray into my heart.
So wait, you did for John Doe, are you going to call the lead singer of Whitesnake and be like, bro, you know, we got to do
is
the...
Is that Tony Katane's husband?
No.
Okay.
Why don't you... Actually, why don't you... Maybe you should Maybe who should you do the metal equivalent if you were going to pick? I don't want to choose for you. If you were going to make two best-selling books on the history of metal, you know, and have someone maybe not. I don't want to. Let's say it's what John Doe is saying is I don't want to do the definitive history of X. Let me just talk about the scene. Who would be the metal equivalent that you would partner up with?
Lemmy's dead, right?
Lemmy's dead.
Lemmy's dead.
I don't know. I've
But for the LA scene, the LA, because the Sunset Strip, no one's actually kind of done that. Right?
It's not in here.
Who has?
The book Nothing But a Good Time.
That's right.
Is the version of
that. Yeah, but
that
wasn't a musician telling
their story. No, it was all
story.
Musicians telling their stories.
That's right. It wasn't one musician telling.
Oh, what an original idea. Can I say that?
It took two writers to do that book.
We stole it from that great book on New York punk rock. When I drawn a blank on it, it's fantastic.
Please kill me.
Please kill me. Yeah.
Wait, what was that, Naughty Guy?
Nothing.
Did I tap the? I think I did a tap tap.
No, I don't. Not he got.
But no, it's
he's
funny.
He's not talking into the microphone, is he?
No, he okay. was banging on the table. He's doing something. Anyways,
all right.
I didn't realize. I forgot about that book, but I'm still interested. If you were going to partner up to hear the stories, would it be Iron Maiden? Because that's who you mentioned.
I wouldn't know how to do that book. To be honest with you,
because you're too in love with Iron Maiden.
Because I'm too. No, I literally when I say I missed it, I missed it. I knew all the stuff that was on MTV. Mm-hmm. I would say begrudgingly at the time, but now I go back and there were great songs. But it was such a.
Oh, so if you're not going to do metal, then what would be the next kind of genre of music that you would tackle?
Heavy metal.
Heavy metal. I love, my favorite city in the world is Memphis. I love Memphis soul.
Oh,
I have a Stax tattoo.
Oh,
cool.
I'm obsessed with that.
Okay, well, let's put it out there. Who would it be?
Oh my God, William Bell. Maybe he would just do
that awesome. Okay, well, let's manifest that shit. Let's,
right on.
Let's get this done by 2024, end of 2024. Let's get the contract in place so that we can expect that book out in 2025.
I get to, and this is a forget it. My job, I've gotten to work with, last month, mm-hmm. I signed William Bell. After stalking him, and he wrote You Don't Miss Your Water, he wrote Born Under a Bad Sign.
I feel like there's a real good chance that this could happen.
He co-wrote Born Under a Bad Sign with someone else I work with, I didn't sign. He came to the company, I got to be his person, which is Booker mm-hmm. T. Jones. And the stories
I'm not, okay. Stax all Records, right. Ahmed Zappa. Yeah. Stax Records is America. Sorry, it's American. On. He's talking about American history. Wait,
keep going.
American history.
Did I say Booker T. Jones?
I meant. Look, listen. Unless you're writing a book about metal, who would want to hear about that? Nobody. No one's ever even heard that music.
The influence that the Stax thing had on metal, specifically LA metal.
No, I'm joking. No. This is amazing, and you should do that.
No, but it's funny, and it's like I was saying to one of you gents earlier. Like it was
when you pointed at Gotti, you know Naughty Gotti. You think he's a gentleman?
Well, look at them.
His name is Naughty Gotti.
He's got a nice sweater.
You have
on.
No air in your tires. The second you parked, he was out there like, fuck that guy in his beard.
He beat COVID in 2 days.
Yeah. COVID didn't have any shot against him.
Just had COVID and just beat it.
Fuck yeah. He's like, you know, just a brand new dog, killed it in his backyard.
I got something that relates to your show's running sequential. Or, yeah, I heard your last mm-hmm. show. So.
Okay.
So my best friend is a chap named Matt Messer, who's been my friend for a million years.
Yep.
And I missed Kiss. Mm-hmm. Completely missed Kiss. And I missed Kiss primarily because my brother is 14 years older than me.
Okay.
And so when they were out, it was like, he was sort of like, they're a boy band. And I was like, sure. And he liked Black Sabbath. So I was like, all right, I'm into Black Sabbath.
Okay. So again, you grew up in a really
unfortunate... For the first time ever,
okay.
A couple months ago, I went to a Kiss concert with my buddy Matt and his daughters.
Yeah, it's the best thing you've ever.
At the Hollywood Bowl.
At the Hollywood Bowl.
Oh, you were there?
I was there.
Okay.
Yeah, you remember me from such things as the audience, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
It was, and it was.
I saw you in the parking lot.
Fun as hell.
Yeah.
It was hilarious.
Shut up.
Hilarious.
How was it hilarious?
Everyone was what I thought they'd look like. It was just like... Whole families in Kiss makeup. It was cosplay.
Okay, but that's not hilarious. That's passion and epicness.
That's Kiss Army.
What I loved is, how old is Paul Stanley? Are we allowed to talk?
He's immortal. Keep going. No, but it doesn't matter.
He's 2003 years old.
No, but he's
71, 72.
Okay, so was anyone else at this rock show? Or are y'all posers?
No, we were all there.
Okay, so we were sitting right by the platform.
Yeah. When fucking Paul flies out of the audience.
But not only did he not fly out, but he did it without a wire.
Yeah.
And I was really impressed. He just kind of got up there. Dude is like in good shape.
It stresses me out. Every time I see him, like, how the fuck does he do? We talked about it. It's incredible that he...
I did have one Kiss single as a kid, a 45.
Mm-hmm. Which was?
What do you think?
You had the best single. Yeah,
The ballads by Alice Cooper and Kiss.
And you know how you guessed that? Because that's punk rock adjacent is basically Lone Justice, that song, which you know and I know,
Beth?
It's
Wheels. Beth.
Wheels. Yeah. Lone Justice is music that I would absolutely, I call it my bathtub mix. Like when I want to check out, I'm in the bath, and I just throw the toaster in.
East of Eden, please.
Oh my God.
By Lone Justice.
Fucking incredible.
Okay. Yeah. We have a perfect segue before we take a break. Yeah. Not to be this guy.
Do we get pizza?
But in our discussion of Kiss, we should mention.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. So Gene was he was on the show and you know, it was a big moment for me. It's Kiss is legitimately my favorite band of all time.
I know a lot of you people.
Well, we're good people. So he had mentioned he's doing this cool thing for the fans. I said I would mention this again for people who don't know. Gene Simmons Recording Studio Events.com. Gene Simmons Recording Studio Events.com. So he mentioned this on the show because he's always, you know, involved in a bunch of stuff and he's always kind of promoting it. I actually think this is cool.
Gene has only recently discovered business.
I was going to say self promotion.
Yeah, it's brand new to him. Yes. Like, oh, yeah. Wait, I can have ideas and make some money on the side.
Do you have one of those coffins?
I didn't get the $10,000 coffin.
So
right?
You're a big fan, though.
My wife has to agree. I feel like this is a conversation. I have to get her on the side. Would, if you asked me, would I be buried in a Kiss coffin if I had to pick right now? 100%.
Right.
There's no doubt about
duh.
It. Yeah, exactly. Duh.
Wait, but wasn't the coffin the ultimate box set? Wasn't that the thing? Didn't it come in a coffin?
No.
Oh, like it comes actually with all the releases?
No, what was the thing?
You're buried with everything,
actually,
too?
Does it?
No, but that he was selling some kind of big thing.
Yeah.
So that's the crate.
Vault. That's
the
vault.
Yeah, that's the vault crate
Oh, that's what it was.
Craziness.
Do you have the vault crate of craziness?
I do not have
huge
the...
Huge fan.
I am a huge fan. I am a huge fan.
Wait, we did have a vault in the office at one point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, you know, they come and go.
Yeah.
As vaults tend to do.
Yeah.
There's a lot of stuff in storage.
Yeah. But I'll just say this. So the event, right? And I tried to just convince him, like, hey, let me just attend as a fan. And he didn't go for it. Because he's like, no. Because the tickets are a certain price. It's like, look, I like you, but yeah, you know.
I'm hoping that that guy finds a way to make some money in this life.
I worry about it.
Hashtag prayers for Gene.
So, just discovered merch. Yeah.
So the event, though, can you guess what it is? I'm curious.
The price of attending in Las Vegas.
In Las Vegas.
The chance to record with Gene, ostensibly in the booth. And you're with some other people.
So is it like karaoke with Gene?
But you're going to record a song.
But it's cool. You get the recording, and then you have the master. You get to distribute it, and there's a way to monetize it, you know, in collection. That's one of the things he's doing.
Gotcha. So we're talking monetization.
He takes 99%.
And he takes 99%.
Right.
I'm going to say... Oh, I'm going to get in trouble here. What I would pay or what I think it would be?
No. I mean, you'd pay because now that you're a Kiss fan after going to the show, you'd pay any amount of money to be in the room. But
$75, $400?
$75, $400?
$75, $2, that's a span, like a little dash in between. No. I'm going to say, just from being an observer to all you Kiss Army folks, I'm going to say it costs $10,000 to do that.
Oh, that's you would be wrong. Because it's, of course, they would never charge that much money. That's too much. It's too much. So if you go to Gene Simmons, Tricky Dicky, please go there. Gene Simmons Recording Studio Events. Gene Simmons Recording Studio Events.com. The very affordable price to be in the room with your hero and record is.
I'm going there right now.
Six. Okay. I think it's six.
Yeah, it's May 4th, 5th sessions.
Gotti, do you have my screen?
Yeah, we can see it up
How
there.
Long is the session? How long do you get? Is it like
it's 6,000, but it's really
day.
For two.
So it's like you're there for the full day.
Okay.
And you'll record a song.
Mm-hmm.
You'll get a copy of the song.
Yep.
You will take home the song.
You'll be shot in the parking lot. By some guy who pulls up in a Ford F-150 with blacked out windows.
Guess how much it was? $6,000.
$6,000. Well, then if you add in...
You're way off, bro.
But if you add in, it's Vegas, travel expenses, hotel.
Yeah, but
you're going to have a nice meal. You're talking 10 grand.
You're way off,
You're talking 10
bro.
Grand.
Oh, my God.
I went to...
Who are these people?
right. Those are examples of you that could be
actual participants.
Yeah.
In the about right before 2020 and the whole mess as well, I went with my aforementioned buddy Matt Messer.
Yeah, are we gonna buy this for Matty Messer?
Yes. Let's get it for him as a gift. We'll all kick in. But
you're gonna buy it?
No.
Now, okay. Keep in mind on the last show, we went shopping at kiss.com. I spent $1,000 because they we pre ordered.
What did you buy
stuff.
For $1,000?
My
stuff.
Fucking Batwing hoodie.
Hoodie.
But I was going around the table. I was like, would you guys want some? I mean, I was trying to throw in, you know, like, let's pick some stuff up. I kind of bought everything.
I was pretty impressed. We went to the Grove.
Yeah.
Because Paul Stanley was putting out a book. And we got in a line, and they did this really amazingly fast. Like, I have a photo with Paul Stanley. Like, 4 years before I ever saw him. And it was pretty impressive. I actually do have a photo with Paul Stanley.
You're a lucky man.
On my phone. Like, taken with my phone. It was an amazingly...
Again, like, I've just...
organic moment. He seems very nice. He seems very
nice.
I'm
going to take a quick...
Paul Stanley seems like... I get... My buddy sends me all his Instagram photos.
He is the nicest.
He makes a lot of pizza at home.
Hey, hey, Paul,
he's been on Rocktails.
Paul, did you like spending time with Paul DeSavia? You're not Paul DeSavia, although you should legally change your name.
Paul DeStanley.
Paul DeStanley.
That was my nickname in high school.
Did you like spending time with DeSavia, Paul?
Tequila!
Okay. On that, we're going to take a quick break. It's Rocktails Live at 5. More with Tom, not Paul DeSavia, when we come right back. After this commercial break, we're going to get into all of the people that might get into the Rock Hall. We're going to vote. I'm curious to see how this all works, and we'll be back in a moment. I got to refill my glass. Cheers. She's radioactive.
Rocktails.
All right. Look at this. It's Rocktails. Oh, Tricky Dicky. What a great bottle of wine. Sea smoke?
Yeah, I drank a couple bottles.
Southing. Delicious. A little Pinot. Good stuff.
Before we get into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame ballot.
Yeah.
Can I ask a question of Tom DeSanley?
Yeah, but don't embarrass him.
This is the weirdest question.
Okay.
Are you wearing... You have wonderful boots on.
Thank you.
Are they from the Thursday Boot Company? Which, by the way, is not...
Okay, this is a
the
really
band Thursday?
Strange question.
No. The company Thursday Boots. This
Wait,
is not
is happening
a sponsee.
Right now?
I have no idea.
This is not a sponsee. I need to know because Brando has been treating himself a little bit lately. I'm going to start referring to myself as a third person.
Do you want to pay me back first?
Is hell freezing over? Are we talking fashion with fucking
I have
Brando
no idea.
Right now?
I bought them off an Instagram ad during the COVID. COVID's
come
up a lot.
They're very good at being on Instagram, which
they're
is how
I saw don't know.
Them.
Are they?
They are Thursday Boots. And I was right.
They're very comfortable. And they've got the zip up so I don't have to tie my shoes.
Can you put that up on the table?
It's a good boot.
Why are you boot stalking?
I said, are you trying to get free boots?
Because I think it's time to like get out of hobo stage. The pandemic is over.
Are you okay at home? Did the hobbler, you know?
So wait, you're looking at this.
The hobbler came down on you and said, "You need to elevate your game."
You're looking at this as getting out of hobo stage. Yeah. Kudos to you, my friend.
Yeah.
You looked at that.
This is your after drink.
Well, I like that he's got the suede jacket that I like too.
Which I gotta say, I love this jacket.
Mm-hmm. Oh my God!
What is this fashion show?
No, but you know when you wear a jacket out and people compliment it,
yeah.
You're like, yeah. I post on the Instagram like I'm a 14-year-old.
Both of you.
What? I and me. And so someone pointed out there that it's like, oh, you're wearing the jacket again, and like in 18 pics. I'm wearing the same jacket because it's my favorite jacket, but now I don't get compliments anymore. Now it's just kind of sad.
Are you both okay?
No.
I mean, look at you and your rock tees and talking about each other's jackets and boots.
No, we're not okay. The 80s are over.
Do either of you have children?
No.
Yeah.
We failed.
I've apparently got a pair of Thursday boots, though.
Well, joining the Rocktails round table, two girls, Brendan J. Smith and Tom DeSavia. Right. They're here to talk about their new fashion line.
Oh, no.
No self-respect.
All right, here are the nominees for the 2024.
All right, let's set it.
Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Let's just reestablish.
Can you see that ballot, Gotti?
Yep.
Okay.
So can I touch that thing? I want to see it for a second.
The book?
I want to touch it.
It is. The arts department did a good job on the ballot.
Wait, so this is, you vote, how many years have you been voting?
Oh, God, like probably almost 20 now.
So are they always this?
Holy shit.
Yeah, yeah. I got in, so I started voting.
Microphone.
I started voting in 2001, so.
Oh, wow. Okay, this, hold that in front of you, because I feel like,
like that, or like in front?
Oh, no, when it comes time to vote, because mm-hmm. I feel like, you know, I want to make sure that people know that's your hand marking the ballots. Would you mind, like, I briefly scanned through it. It's pretty interesting. They do like simple page on each artist.
Oh, wow.
Mary J. Blige. Mariah Carey, Cher, Dave Matthews Band, Eric B. and Rakim? How do you say that?
Rakim.
Foreigner. Oh, yeah. Peter Frampton. Jane's Addiction, Kool and the Gang. Awesome. We got some good choices, right? Lenny Kravitz, Oasis. Oh, fuck yeah.
This might be the best ballot ever.
Yeah,
this
Sinead really O'Connor, Ozzy Osbourne.
Sinead, Ozzy.
Sade. Tribe Called
Your
Quest.
Your Love Is King. Yeah. Wow. Zappa.
You know what? That's the first time then like 90% of the bands. Some years I'm like, they should not be voted in. This is a tough one.
It's usually a really easy 7 votes for me. And sometimes it's like, oh, who do I give the last two to? Mm-hmm. The only problem with this year.
Well, let's see the ballot page again. So they send this to you.
Yes.
So any ding-dong could steal this from your mail and, like, fucking, you know, tick the box and then you're...
But that would be wrong. Yeah.
Okay.
But then this like, is a little perforated. It comes with a little self-addrum stamped envelope. And you mail it in.
Okay.
The only problem is Warren Zevon was on the ballot last year, didn't get in.
Yeah.
And I think that
was a tragedy.
And he didn't make it this year. So that's my.
So why don't they include him the next year? Because they did that with Iron Maiden as well.
I think, and this is the problem. I don't totally understand the process. Meaning, because there's no preliminary voting, and it was funny. I was actually on the board for a few years.
Okay. Oh.
But.
So what is that? What does that mean? How many people are on the board?
I don't know. We never met.
I don't think you're supposed to say that.
I'm not supposed to say that. Please keep me on the voting. I'm going to lose my voting status.
No,
it's been a good run.
This is the
if
last
I lose
year.
It, it's fine. I've had a good run. So I was hired at Elektra Records 100 years ago by one of the absolute greats of this business, a guy named Seymour Stein.
Okay, yes.
And
unbelievable story.
I mean, signed everything. He signed the Smiths and the Talking Heads and Madonna and the Ramones and the Pretenders and on and on. I mean,
by the way, love his family.
Mandy,
the whole tribe.
They're just wonderful people. Yeah. And I went to ASCAP from Elektra.
To save animals from being put down?
To save, yes. To stop that dog barking next to your house.
ASCAP is animal saving. Cooperative.
Cooperative
American animals so protective.
And pandas. So they, yeah. they save animals, or they are in charge of killing animals at ASCAP. I'm just...
It depends on the state. It's a really specific thing, yeah.
Okay, thank you for clarifying.
So at that point on the board was another wonderful woman who's passed in the last year, a woman named Marilyn Bergman, a great American songwriter.
But literally... the brought to life Hanna-Barbera character Birdman.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
And right. she
just to make sure we're all.
And so he was like, and she called me. She's like, she'd always send me her ballot, mm-hmm. and she's like, you fill it out. So maybe it was 2002. So
I went there. Again, another thing I don't think you're supposed to say.
You're not supposed.
I mean,
to.
But I would never have done that. And then Seymour called me and said, he said, why don't you just? I'll put you on the board. And so for like 3 or 4 years, I was on the board, which got me a great seat. At the thing, and I saw some amazing shows when it was at the
Rock and Roll Hall of Fame show.
Well, Rock and Roll Hall of Fame show at the Waldorf Astoria, and those were like Blondie and Patti Smith.
So, do you still get great seats?
No. Now I'm a voter with a lot of other people.
Okay.
And I was on the board for I don't know maybe 3-4 years, and then I've just remained a voter, and I love it, because it's just, you know, I feel I'm a Grammy voter too. Mm-hmm. I feel connected to.
Do you feel like Tom is just bragging right now?
I'm also
it's just like in your eye, in your eye, in
are
your
you,
eye.
Do you also vote for president too?
Yeah,
do you make
well,
us all feel ashamed? Like none of us all have that privilege. You know, none of us not all of us can vote for presidents. Fuck.
I got nothing.
The real vote. Yeah. The secret vote for presidents.
This is the one that I feel probably the most connected to.
Right.
Because, as you just read, it's all
but
our
it does
DNA.
Feel like this might... if anyone's
go away after I appear on the show.
Because if anyone listened to you on previous shows, because we've done this, 3 or 4 times now with you.
Yeah. First time I brought the ballot on, though. That's
I know.
Why. This is going to be my downfall.
It's a behind the scenes, right? And it does, the way that you've just described
let's go with that.
We're like, oh, no, just you vote for me, really makes it feel like a well-oiled machine.
Well, but I always appreciated that. Marilyn felt she couldn't accurately vote on rock and roll, and her vote would have been wasted.
Okay.
And so, and that's why I think it was like, she was like, I need help. Who are these bands? What do they mean? She, you know, it was a lot of obvious names everyone knew, but I doubt she had an opinion on the New York punk rock scene that was just getting into the Hall of Fame about that time. And so somehow until tonight, they haven't figured out that I shouldn't be a voter. So this may be my last year.
This is definitely your last year of this, Justin. Well, let's get this valid ballot.
Right on.
Like issued, sent in. So let's actually go through it. Shall we play just a because there are really hard decisions. Who are the artists again?
Well, again, we only get to pick 7 of these.
From what I remember, because I'm really kind of learning this for the first time, in no particular order of favorites, I would absolutely put Oasis, Foreigner.
Wait, let's go through it. Okay. Let's go through it.
Well, here's the list of nominees.
Okay.
We can only get 7. Mary J. Blige.
Okay.
Mariah Carey.
Mm-hmm.
Cheryl Sarkeesian. Dave Matthews Band.
Mm-hmm.
Eric B. and Rakim. Foreigner. Frampton. LA's Jane's Addiction.
Mm-hmm.
Cool and the Gang.
Mm-hmm.
Lenny Kravitz, Oasis,
yep.
Sinead O'Connor, The Prince of Darkness, Sade, and A Tribe Called Quest.
Okay.
Did you call Cher the Prince of Darkness?
Yeah.
The original Princess of Darkness.
I was born wagon of a traveling show. Mama used to dance with the money they throw. Papa would do whatever.
Squeedly ball.
Preaching little gospel, selling extra bottle of Dr. Good.
All right, let's just do let's go down.
Papa would have shot him if he knew what he'd done.
Let's sample a little music and then let's vote. Here we go. Mary J. Blige.
Yes. I think. Can I talk? Yeah, we don't want to wait.
Okay,
But did she say get it percolating?
Yes. This is a song actually about
percolating.
Coffee.
Percolating. That's not the... is that the proper way to say it? Percolating?
She's one of those people. Okay. And I know it's...
She's going to get in.
She should. Yeah. She's a fucking...
There's no should. She is going to get in because the man wants her in.
Oh, no. Let me just say it this way.
Okay. Am I the
what
man?
Mary J. Blige wants, okay, because she's such a force of nature.
Yeah.
Mary J. Blige gets.
Yeah. Okay.
So
yeah.
Let's just start okay, there.
But do we right, think she should be in?
Let's go around. Okay. Tom, should she get in?
Fuck yeah.
Okay.
Tom fuck yeah. Says, absolutely. Yeah. Powerhouse singer. Amazing. Trailblazer.
No, but okay. She's going to get in.
Okay.
That's called being Amit. Defeated.
I you, have, not her. I have her first rock record and her second metal record.
Okay. Right.
So I mostly appreciate her rock records.
Okay, so zero.
So as much as Mary, you're going to get in because it's what you demand. I am a of the frame of mind. It's called the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. And yeah. You know, I compartmentalize
so only,
shit.
Only we've blues lost that artists, battle. Only blues artists from the turn of the century oh, should
only,
be.
We have lost that battle. People
that battle is
that
we
stole
lost that
music
battle.
From other people that electrified
you,
it.
You yeah, totally I, lost I, that I, battle. I,
we I, lost I, that battle I, a long
she
time.
She actually had that great. She did that great version of One with U2, and that vocal yeah. is fucking powerful. She's a great singer. I don't subscribe
I
to the thing that
she's
only rock and roll should be flying V guitars.
She's an amazing actress. She's an amazing singer, performer. Totally authentic, but I genuinely, if I'm being really, really honest, how I would have attacked this list yeah. is to say, well, what are the people, and we'll go down the list, but yeah, I would say what I think off the top is a rock band. I would say, okay, here are the first people I would put in would be Lenny Kravitz, Oasis, Ozzy Osbourne, all of the rock bands, yeah, and we'll get to that. But like Mary J. Blige right now, my first instinct is, if you're asking me at the top and I have to decide right now, I'm like, that's a maybe? Can I hear?
We can go back and change our vote.
Yeah, so you're on record with Oka Buki. Beaver?
Okabookie Beaver is yeah. coming out.
Okabookie Beaver.
Okabookie Beaver. Mary, do yeah. a record with Okabookie Beaver.
I was... Yeah. I got to see her live a couple of times, and you know, it's the age-old argument: what is rock and roll?
Well,
Richard Sheltenga.
Wait, hold on, Dolly Parton.
We're only on number one.
We're
right?
only on
number one.
Yeah. Wait, here's my point, and I think Dolly actually backs up mm-hmm. my feelings. She's like, wait, I don't need this vote, right? But other people decided she needed to be in the Rock Hall. People, I think, would say that she's a country artist. And then, so what did she do so that she felt more comfortable? She's like, fuck it. I'm going to make a kick-ass
But
rock
I would argue that
record.
Jolene was hugely influential. It's the hallelujah for rock bands.
Richard Sheltenga. Mary J. yeah. Blige.
It's
not yet.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
There you go. We moving on?
To Mariah Carey.
Okay.
Somehow the one that I needed no. would
find me no. if I will say this, though, okay? So if it became like... If there was a slot for number seven, right, and it was between Mary J. Blige and Mariah Carey, if that's how the it all worked out, and I said who to me is more mm-hmm. rock and roll, because I think rock and roll also is like attitude as well. I think Mary J. Blige to me is certainly more rock and roll than Mariah Carey.
That's a good
Absolutely.
Argument.
Yeah.
I agree with that.
So that's a
yeah.
no from
yeah,
me.
Yeah, I think we're universalness. Yeah. Sorry, Mariah.
God bless her.
Yeah,
one of
God
the biggest
bless you.
Pop stars in the history of pop stars.
Look, it's going to be a tough year for you, Mariah, because you lost out to Brenda Lee. You were the top spot with your Christmas hit, and Brenda Lee should be in the Rock Hall before you are in the Rock Hall.
Boom.
If I could turn now, well.
No, I think Cher 100%
hard no.
Hard no.
Hard no. Hard
no. No,
and I'm going to tell
no.
you why. Sorry,
yeah,
Cher.
Yeah, tell me why you're so stupid right now.
Because of what she brought to the world with Auto-Tune. I'm still mad about it.
Okay.
No.
Let's go back to the Sunset Strip.
She'll get in.
Let's go back to the Sunset Strip circa 1965.
Yeah.
Ben Franks, if you're having a fucking like eggs and ham.
How old
and
are you?
Sonny and Cher walk in. Your mind is fucking blown. Yeah. She gave birth to an almond. She
Who among us has
fucking Gene Simmons?
Yes. These are all fucking great points.
And Sonny and Cher are not in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Yeah.
Okay, can we go around the table, Cher?
Cher, yes.
I'm a no.
Yeah.
I will listen. Shogun has inspired me to buy swords because the show is so good on Hulu, and I may or may not have a short sword in my trunk. When you go outside, I'm going to behead you because that's bullshit, bro. Cher's getting in.
Oh, she's getting in. I think she's getting in.
Yeah, and you're voting for
Richard.
Her.
Yes.
Oh, Dave Matthews is number four.
No.
But I have.
Yes. Thank you for agreeing with common sense.
I have multiple reasons, but
yeah,
I have a very controversial opinion of this.
Oh, please tell me.
I don't think that bands that are actively huge touring bands should be admitted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Why? My whole thing is I don't think people should
get... Because there's
so
many people that aren't in it. And if you're, and I think it means something more. I think it's just another award, another accolade.
What if the Rolling Stones were up for...
I mean, okay, when you pass the 50-year mark, it's fine.
Tom.
And they invented rock and roll.
I think... Whatever your reasons are, I just want to give you a medical reason.
Right.
Okay? The CDC does not want people to get Dave Matthews poisoning. So... And it's controversial to say this, okay?
You smell like patchouli.
But when you have this kind of a platform, chances are people will start listening to the music more,
right.
And then you're indoctrinated, and then you get Dave Matthews poisoning.
Okay, let's go around the table. Tom, are you in or not?
That is a no for me.
No.
God, that's
Brandon?
That is a big, crunchy, patchouli-smelling no.
No,
did a song with Cher?
I think honestly, this was a friendship test, and Tom and Brando, you failed, and of course, Dave, all of those horns, all of that weird smell when they're playing horns, like it probably smells fine, right? Like if you went up to give one of those band members a kiss, it wouldn't smell like a homeless person's anus.
This is a no.
It's a light no from me. I think you get it.
But if you want to perform Dave Matthews right here on the Rocktail stage acoustically.
No, I'm sure Dave Matthews is like the best person to hang out with. And I would say to Dave, hold on. Dave, my wine glass got stuck to my cocaine coaster. Hold on. I said the word.
I'm going to say yes, say well.
You know the drill.
Cocaine.
Everyone has to do a shot if I say cocaine.
Cocaine.
So, Dave, I'm talking to you, Dave. Listen, if you want to get into the Rock Hall, all I ask is that you just rock. Is that so hard? Simple. Just rock. Cool. Moving on. Tricky Dicky?
Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
Eric B. and Rakim.
Yes. Well, now.
Don't love him.
This is what I think, right? It feels like they're pitting people for political reasons, right? Because you have Eric B, right, and Rakim, and I'm saying it right,
yes.
Right? And then my wife loves this band and also loves De La Soul at the end?
No, Tribe.
A Tribe Called Quest.
Right. But like, it feels like they're pitting Mary J. Blige against Mariah Carey and like similar.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Like, is that a thought process?
It's,
you know how it works.
I don't know, but
scenes.
It is. It's a tough, like, this, like we were talking earlier, this is really a hard year. Yeah. So there's some no's that are going to be hard no's. There's some that are going to be no's just because there are other people that I really like. Mm-hmm. This one's tough for me. I haven't decided yet. I like Eric B. and Rakim.
But do you stack? See, here's the thing. I compartmentalize like this. I go through it. I'm like, okay, no, these are actually rock bands. And these are people trying to shift, like, yeah, this could be a hip hop group, can be a rock band, right? And Mariah Carey, she's a rock star.
Yeah,
right?
I mean, I think it's more, should they change it to the Music Hall of Fame?
I agree. If they called it that, I'd be like, great, yes, all of them should get in. It's a tragedy.
But you would put Cher,
still seven.
You would put Cher in the Rock Hall of Fame just because she dated Gene Simmons?
No, because she rocks. So we established that. She was on a battle cruiser in a thong with her
Sarkeesian
son, which is
fucking rocks.
Yeah. All right, let's
she
go
moved
around
to Hollywood.
All right, let's go around the table. Eric B. and Rakim.
That's a yes for me.
That's a no. Hip Hop Hall of Fame.
Can you just do me a favor?
Yeah.
Can you play me? Not that this is the comparison, right? I mean, this feels like this is still don't move but the money. Groovy and rocky. Like,
did you like Run DMC and Aerosmith?
Yeah, of course.
Was that rock and roll?
You have only seven choices, by the way.
Yeah, that's what's tough.
But that's
what's going to piss you guys off.
That's why it's hard for me to decide how many more do we have left, because this might be
a
maybe
lot
for
more.
Me. This is a maybe.
Yeah,
that's why I keep.
That's fair. Because I have can I do maybe?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is a maybe.
Hip Hop Hall of Fame. Like Godfathers.
Yes.
Yes.
There you go.
Richard, what do you think about Eric B. and Rakim in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame?
I'm going to say no for now.
Okay.
Yeah.
Foreigner is next.
Yes. Yes. Can you play Star Rider? J. just on this song alone. Play Star Rider, but get to the chorus. After Lou Gramm comes in, just fast forward a little bit. This is my track. Shane, if you're watching,
hey baby,
it's our song,
babe. Crank
it, here we go. Ready?
Speed increasing, all control is in the hands of those who know. Will they help us grow to one day be Star Rider?
Was this the tune that the Stonehenge came down?
Yeah.
Yes. Whatever. Yes. Give it to me. Give it all to me.
It's so, the Foreigner Rush song.
So yeah. Going to our discussion, what's our goal? Yeah. This was not foundational for me personally.
So is this a maybe? This,
so this is a maybe, probably a no.
Brendan?
What? Foreigner?
Yeah.
Oh, 100%.
It's the crime that okay, 100%
for me too. So
okay.
Let's.
Here, Mark. Okay. By the way.
Yeah.
Whatever happens tonight. Your fucking hand. If I have to stab you in the neck and hold your hand to mark Foreigner, you're marking Foreigner tonight.
Okay.
They were two tickets to paradise, right?
I better hear a live song right here, Richard. Yeah.
This should be, by the way, our first yes.
Yes.
This is our first. If we were going to say, what would be the first one you would mark? This would be my first one I would mark.
I can't believe he's not already there.
Yeah, this is a yes.
Yes, a big yes.
Not my first yes.
But it's still a big yes.
But it's a yes, yeah.
But the decision to do this is because he was in the Sgt. Pepper
absolutely.
Movie.
He played Billy Shears.
Yeah.
Okay, wait. So Peter Frampton for me is a humongous yes.
Yes.
But
yes.
Most people, I think a lot of our viewers or listeners... probably agree. An unbelievable guitar player.
Well,
so 100%. If you're gonna kind of talk about the level of musicianship, where you know if you take a Mary J. Blige or a Mariah Carey, they're great vocalists, but like the Rock Hall. But in this, there's so many things that go into the ingredients as to why you should be in.
Backwards.
James.
Yeah,
did you ever see James early on in
I
Los
did. I saw them at the Whiskey, and I saw them at, and it was the show. This is an interesting factoid. I saw them at some point, it was probably 91 or something like that, and they played the John Anson Ford Amphitheater for like a bunch of nights in a row and shut that venue down for rock and roll for like a decade because it was so loud.
So this is not... my band. They have never been my band.
Same.
I do not. I can appreciate this. Like for me, like Lou Gramm as a singer, as a rock singer,
right.
Is like, oh my god, 100% should be in the Rock Hall. I mean the.
He was the two tickets to paradise guy.
No.
Right.
No,
oh my god. Oh my god.
I guess the point I'm trying to make is a unique band. So many people love them. Right, they're kind of like, and maybe you have different opinions about them. Again, not my band. Love the players, love the art that they made, but it was never the thing where I was gonna turn it up. Right,
that's my Foreigner thing. That's what I mean. It's the same thing. They weren't my band.
I guess we're flip flopping, but yes, they should be in because I do think I can appreciate the impact that they've had, and it's the only time steel drums. Ever sounded cool.
All right, let's go around. All right. Tom?
It's a maybe for me. And going by what you said, deserving so, but it
for
might
me,
not
it's
make
a
my
yes,
seven.
But sadly, they should be behind Thin Lizzy, Motorhead, and Iron Maiden.
Yeah, but I think on the list, I don't know how many. I don't know if I need to
I would
hold
give
this
all
yes.
seven votes to Thin Lizzy.
Just say yes or no.
I would that say yes. But
Thin Lizzy are one of my favorite bands of all time.
Yeah, no.
And that's what I mean. Are they not in?
Nope. No.
That's a crime.
Yep.
That's a crime.
3 years ago, I think they were nominated, right?
That's
or
a crime.
Or didn't get nominated.
They are.
They did get nominated, yeah, but they didn't
but
get
But they are, I think, it's like, ridiculous. They're in a top. They're a top 10 band.
It's a joke.
Yeah.
Okay. Next band. Well.
Cool again.
You want to get out? By the way, opened up for Van Halen on the 2012.
I saw it. Yeah. I saw it because they're David
and
Roth's favorite band.
And blew Van Halen off the stage.
And they're Roth's favorite band, right? Which also made sense. I saw Van Halen that year, and those year earlier, I'm like, oh my god, he's a song and dance guy. It just hit me.
Cool in the gang.
Here's
yes.
Yes.
And I because
now why?
because they're fucking playing their instruments and crushing it. You know what I mean? Like, I have to say, like, the some of the other choices, they're just vocalists.
I got into these records. I have a couple of buddies that started this magazine called Wax Poetics a bunch of years back.
And did you say yes? Sorry, Richard. I didn't mean to interrupt you. Go. Did you say yes?
Wait, I said no.
What? Why, Richard?
No one cares.
No, I don't care.
No, but I went back. They were a band I only knew the singles from, which were fucking slamming.
Wait, hold on a second. Yeah. Sorry. So, Poison, did they get in?
They should.
No.
Okay. Let me just say this, right? Yeah. I think that Poison will get... Bon Jovi, did they get in?
I'm sure they're
yes.
in.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
They must be, yeah.
They got in, right?
They must. I don't know, but I'm
bought
assuming
their way
yes.
in.
Yeah. Payola.
Yes. Jason, you're definitely canceled. You're never voting again.
They've
got to
be. They've got to be. But I don't know.
Here's what I'll say. A power ballad, right?
Mm-hmm.
There's plenty of rockers that got in because of a power ballad. Is that fair to say?
Yeah, like Foreigner.
By the way, so many babies were made. Like,
that's
thank
true.
Goodness.
Is that a good thing?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
And well. So, Cherish the Love from fucking Kool and the Gang. How many adorable babies were fucking made?
Yeah.
Because people were putting their weird fucking genitals together, making magic.
I fell in love with myself. From that song. Yeah. That's what made me feel I'm roller skated to this song,
that,
guaranteed.
Isn't it weird that humans, like, they fucking get into a sandwich and then babies are born?
Not when you hear this song. It makes perfect sense.
Yeah. Hold on. Let's hold hands again.
Is this how babies are made? This is how I thought babies were made when I was 28.
Babies are made in the butt. Oh, it's so good. God bless you, Kool and the Gang. Yeah, cheers.
But I did.
Welcome to the Rock Hall, Kool and the Gang.
When I was in, like, junior high, there was a lot of, like, roller skating events.
Yeah.
The roller skating thing. And this was definitely roller skating. Yeah.
I bet you and I, because you mentioned the magic word of roller skating,
yeah.
I used to go to Flippers in Boys Town.
Right on
Santa Monica and Los Angeles.
That was you?
Yeah.
That's before that was...
I was in Thousand Oaks.
Oh, yeah,
doing it. Yeah.
People should know that. It's a CVS now? Yeah. It was a roller rink.
Yeah. It was a roller rink.
It was a fucking killer roller rink.
Yeah.
It was the closest roller rink.
Cool and they said punchers. Yes.
In?
Yes.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes. 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 Yes.
Pay attention. Of course he's in.
Yes.
We did the yes. yes. And yes. you said no.
Yes, yes, yes. The next entry.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, 100%.
Just won the American Music Awards... Icon award.
Yeah.
And he performed with his band Lip Syncing.
Have you seen the last video where he's basically like RK321? Can you play that new fucking whatever it is where he's like referencing Star Wars? He's butt naked in the music video. It's fucking epic.
On the fly.
He's a very handsome man.
Tell me about your best day with Lenny Kravitz.
So we did a cover of a Lennon song, Give Peace a Chance, right? And it was kind of like he was trying to do a We Are the World situation. He did. I mean, we got a bunch of musicians together. And I got invited to do this. This is when I'm maybe 15 or 16. And I forget where it was. He was the producer. And it's one of the first times I'd ever, you know, gone into a studio. And he's like, okay, I want you to sing. And like he... was like, wow, you have
did you really... do like, all we are saying is give peace.
And you can find this video. You can find it if you want to see it. And that same day, this fucking track. Wait, turn it up. This is brand new Kravitz. And it's a Star Wars reference.
Hell yeah. I haven't heard this.
It's fucking good. Watch the music video. You might chub up and feel weird about it. But
2024, they need to feel weird.
Yeah. All aboard, now it's time to face your fear. Yeah. Welcome to the Rock Hall, like, Lenny.
Jason Momoa, listen to my new song.
Yeah. He's like, you know that Jason's like, I get it. It's awesome. But let's just get to the fucking, bruh. You know that that's what's happening, right?
Okay. Let's just get to the fucking.
I get it.
Lenny Kravitz.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I was going to say no, but I've been pulled to the Kravitz side.
Yeah, how
and it's kind of going to say no.
It's kind of moved from a like a maybe just because of numbers, and then after listening to it, I was like, oh yeah.
But I also know that like Lenny Kravitz has been to Okie Dog on Fairfax.
Okay.
Lenny Kravitz is fucking pure rock and roll. If you fucking cut off his hand, not only would it grow back, but what would grow would be a fucking tree that just is like, it's all gold records.
Yeah. And his offspring.
Yeah. First of all, magic. Any part of him makes gorgeous other great things. Have you purchased from his CB2 collection? Oh my God. His chairs?
Does he have a candle that smells like him? Is it one of those?
Yes.
It smells like moving on up.
Yes.
Is that a yes?
It's three yeses.
Okay. Four yeses.
World Market yeses. Has the Kravitz candle at all
This, I mean, well. Don't you know
you might find. So my pre-ramble to this, then if you see, they've come out and went, no, we don't care.
We're talking about Oasis
I'm
now.
Sorry, wait, wait.
Oasis
have
said
home.
Liam. I think Liam has come out.
Liam said, life. "Fuck off, rock and roll."
Fuck off, rock and
yeah.
Having said that,
yep.
Who did you say was your ultimate first yes? Was it Foreigner? You said hard yes for
no,
if
my,
you have
my, my well, Peter Frampton.
Peter
out
Frampton.
Of everyone on the list, I think the out of like rock and roll that's been ignored longer.
He's
that should
Frampton
have been in sooner.
Right.
Frampton would be the person I would say should have already been in.
I would get a full back Oasis logo tattoo given the opportunity. I fucking love them.
I
love the later records. I love everything. I love the Liam records.
If I was King Charles,
speak right now.
If I was King Charles, I would command.
And you are.
That Noel and Liam fucking get their shit together do.
Oh, they will.
My four shows at Wembley.
That is the only thing I would travel out of the country to see.
My prediction?
Yeah. At this, I would travel to that.
Well,
me too.
The money was on the table.
Yeah.
And apparently Noel said no.
Yeah. The money's always been on the table.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
I don't think it'll
happen.
I don't think it will. And it bums me out. And I thought if it was going to happen.
But maybe they should play for like a dog charity, ASCAP. You know
During COVID, Liam put out the olive branch, like, "Oh my God, the world might be ending. We should do this." And he was like, "No."
You know why this will happen?
What is it?
Is because Liam is fine on his own right now, and he's selling more tickets
than Noel.
And Noel eventually is going to want to get this band back.
I was not a BDI fan, which was the first Liam spinoff of it. I mean, it was fine, but I didn't really get into it. I think the two Liam albums are fucking stellar.
Yeah,
they're excellent.
And the new record, you heard the new record with John Squire from the Stone Roses?
Amazing.
It's literally if Oasis and Stone Roses had a baby.
Yeah, that's right.
It's so fucking good.
That's why Noel's going to do this.
Were we at the Oasis show at the Palace in Hollywood?
No. I didn't get to see them until, I think it was a Palladium show. I wish I would have seen them.
Universal Amphitheater.
I saw them at the Amphitheater.
We saw them at Universal.
You got me. I still have regrets. Brando, he's the only person that ever bought me rock tees. Maybe my brother-in-law. I think TV's Patrick Muldoon.
Yeah.
Starship Troopers Patrick Muldoon.
The orange Oasis shirt.
I fucking don't have it. Yep. And it was like, it's great.
That was Universal Amphitheater with Travis. The opening band.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So Oasis.
John Isbell, were you there at the Universal Amphitheater?
I saw my track jacket I bought at that show.
You bought the fucking track jacket. It was blue, right?
Blue. I've got it. I should have worn it tonight. Had I been smart.
And the Thursday boots.
Was it blue with a brown stripe, right?
Blue with a stripe. Yeah.
The two ugliest colors you can have for merch. Like a light baby blue with brown.
Say it again. Like I fucking love Oasis.
Yeah, they're great.
I love them. Yeah, I will never play Wonderwall at a party
because
because I think that's like the worst thing anybody could ever do to anybody. But I think they're just unimpeachable.
Yes. That's a yes, yes, yes all around. Richard Schultinga?
No.
Can I do this at this point with the table?
No, it's a yes.
Okay. Why?
I love Oasis.
I never want to meet Liam, though.
But?
No, he's saying yes now.
You're saying yes.
He's being tricky dicky. He was switching.
That's
you.
One of those artists I never want to meet, though, because I just think Liam would hate me.
I want him to hate me. I don't care.
I know. I love him so much. I actually met. He opened for The Who again right before COVID.
Yep. Uh-huh. At the Bowl.
And we went. I went with my buddy Jeff Sosnow, And I went with a few friends.
Fucking Tommy. All he does is fucking name
it. Name drop all of it.
But Liam was late because
of the traffic.
Because of the traffic.
The traffic. And Liam only played like three songs. Yeah. And he brought us backstage, and I have a photo literally standing about this far from him, and I couldn't. It was like there's a photo of me with him in the background.
Because you were so embarrassed.
I was terrified.
Embarrassed about what was happening in your pants. I get it.
Oh, yeah. 100%.
Next artist, Sinead. Oh. Sinead O'Connor. May she rest in peace.
May she rest in peace.
Okay. I love her. I don't think. I mean, I love this record. I like it, you know. Give me some Mandinka. Is that what this is?
Yeah.
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 I don't know, no, babe. I'm in the shade. Is that how it goes?
Wow.
So, can a name drop again?
Oh, my God.
Oh, are you going to tell me about the time you thought you hooked up with Sinead O'Connor?
Exactly, and it turned out to be you.
And, by the way,
so best awkward.
Night of your life.
Amazing.
Because look at this.
I didn't know anything beyond. I mean, the hit is incredible. Nothing compares to you. Yeah. It's just one of the great vocal performances.
She has more hits than that.
Right. No, but that was the first song you got introduced to. And it was,
oh, you're out?
He's out.
Oh, geez.
And in so about 2000... And I hesitate to say this. I was A&R-ing Linda Ronstadt, Emmylou Harris record. And when I say A&R-ing...
Isn't that about the time that you reached out to the family and got a hard no for the Remington Razor?
I got a hard no for the Remington Razor commercial from your mom. She was like, no, we're going to be releasing that ourselves. What happened?
Like, what could have shit around.
But no, it was...
Okie dokie beater.
They did a cover, and I didn't really know her material past the hits. And they did a cover of a song called this. And when I say A&R, I mean sign the invoices.
Right.
They needed no creative input from me. They were nice enough to let me watch. I had nothing to do with anything creative with this record.
Were you in the studio?
I was in the studio. And they cut a song called This Is
To
Mother
You. Do
you
tell us the story in the microphone? You want people to guess?
There you go. Wait, so they did a... No, they did the song called This Is To Mother You that was off a then recent EP.
Uh-huh.
And I went listening and went, wow. And then I went back and started to listen to her stuff. And it was, my mind was blown by her output. And it was everything. And there's a reggae record that Sly and Robbie did.
See, now you're turning me, because I was, I was a no.
No.
But now you're kind of telling
me. It was the same thing. It was what you did with Kravitz right now. Because I was like, probably no, because of Room. And then we started listening. I'm like, yeah, he's in.
Yeah.
But it was someone that I sort of accidentally did a deep dive on.
So this is a yes.
So it's a yes.
I love her, but... I'm a no because I only have 7.
There you go.
Okay, well, you know what? You disconnected, so you probably really didn't hear anything he was saying. So,
she saved my life once, man.
Yeah.
Oh, she did?
No.
Don't let Tom down. I get it. She's got an incredible voice.
She's amazing. She's in the Irish Rocker Hall of Fame.
Yeah. But
we don't need to vote for her. She made it to the Irish Rocker Hall of Fame.
Had I not done that deep dive.
No, you're good. She's in the Irish Rocker Hall of Fame.
Which I did accidentally.
So I'm a no. Change mine to a no.
Wonderful facility on the Dingle Peninsula.
Wait, are you a no?
No, she did the Irish. She's already in a.
So here's
she's a no. Pogues, you two, Sinead, Waterboys. It's an amazing place. You should go.
Are the Ghetto Boys in the Irish Rock Hall of Fame?
Yes, they are. It's
incredible. I like britches, all kinds of
britches. They love
britches.
So
I'm a britches.
The hip hop scene.
Holes a night.
In
I'll
Cork.
Put a rubbing on there.
Mm-hmm. They like Cork. Love the Ghetto Boys.
Well, if Ozzy doesn't get in, is where I will set fire to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Well, let's remember that Ozzy's in with Black Sabbath.
So
if Ozzy got in and Peter didn't, I think that would be wrong.
That's kind of a good point.
That's an interesting point, but...
No, Ozzy should get in.
Ozzy should be in. The only other double winners are Clapton.
Mm-hmm. Stevie Nicks, right?
Isn't Stevie Jim? Nicks, yeah, very nice. Yeah.
Jimmy Page.
A couple of the Beatles, of course.
I think the drummer from Ambrosia.
Yeah, absolutely. that guy.
His impact on rock and roll.
Yeah.
People don't know. Dave.
All right, let's go around. Tom, Ozzy?
Yes.
You? Yeah?
That'd be yes.
Okay.
That's yes.
All right, I think
we're 4.
That's 4 of us.
Okay.
I love this.
Okay, wait. Are we done through the list?
No, no, we got two more. We got. We're almost done. We got two more.
I don't know what my numbers are going to add up when I actually do this. Hard fucking yes.
Well, wait, what's hard?
Me. Yeah.
This is
Sade.
Before Viagra,
yes,
there was the small blue pill called
this.
Sade. How the fuck is it this?
Do you like? I like Style Council.
Sade.
Which this was before.
I'm. Please tell me why her name is Sade when it's like basically as a dumb American, it's Sade.
I remember getting this record when it first came out.
I mean, give me the way to say it in the spelling, and like it's Sade.
Right? No, it's Sade, but it's also Ralph Fiennes. It's like screw you. It's not Rafe. It's like me saying my name is Tom. It's pronounced Stephen. You know?
Okay.
No, but my introduction to this record.
Yeah.
When I was a kid, growing up in L.A., there was
a record
store.
This is not a rock record, so this is a hard no for me, and I love her.
In Woodland Hills.
By the way, she is immortal. She looks amazing.
Oh, she looks incredible.
She's never aged, and she is a fantasy figure of mine, so that if she wants to get into the Fantasy Hall of Fame.
When this record came out, I was like 15 maybe or so, and I befriended these two punks at a record store called Blue Meanie.
Were you trying to explain to them, like, listen, guys, this gives me feelings in my pants.
No, and what it was is this record came out for like, it was like 6 months or a year before it came out in the U.S. And my friends that worked there, these guys, Lance and Jeff, who were the guys that really indoctrinated me into punk rock.
They did what?
They indoctrinated me. Indoctrinated me.
Okay, cool.
And they took me to my first X show at the Country Club. Okay. Those were these guys.
They indoctrinated you into that too.
They were big into. They turned me onto the Jam.
Are we indoctrinating?
I'm so indoctrinated right now.
Okay, cool.
But they brought me, and this buddy of mine,
Lance.
Do you
have an induct truck?
Like,
you drive an induct truck around town and just indoctrinate
everyone. Cool. You've never been indoctrinated. Again, cast the first stone on it.
We're friends. I've been indoctrinated.
But they went. Listen to this really obscure, weird, alternative, nothing sounds like it record. Nothing sounded like it. There was nothing out there like this. And it was sold to me by punk rockers, and the only place you could buy it was in little indie punk rock stores. And then she became a huge, influential pop star.
Yeah.
When I first heard it, it was like nothing I'd ever heard.
Do you know what this album reminds me of?
What's that?
Never being picked up by your parents.
Where were you? I was left
at daycare, and this was the only cassette tape.
Amazing.
And I learned how to play cards with strangers there. So, like, school would end.
I
was indoctrinated into the waiting game of, like, do your parents care about you? Right? Like, not like, oh, they're going to be 10 minutes late, 20 minutes late. I'm talking... We all have to leave late. Do you have parents? Do they care about you, parents? Just so you know.
Amma, do you need a ride home?
Well, there was one lady there who really liked Sade that I would have taken a ride with her.
You would have indoctrinated by her?
Yeah. Please, sir, can I have some
Tom,
money?
Sade, yes or no? We got to wrap this up.
That's a yes.
I'm sorry. I love her, but
that's a no.
Yeah. And it's because when I heard it, it was a rock and roll.
Fantasy Hall of Fame, yes.
Tribe Called Quest?
Hard fucking yes.
Yeah.
1,000% absolutely getting my vote.
This is.
We're going to get a hip hop band in. It's not going to be Eric B. and Rakim. It's going to be a Tribe Called Quest.
Yeah, Tribe will get in. As they should.
On the longest Rock Tales ever.
My wife, right? I'm giving her my vote, and this would be my wife voting on behalf through me. Tonight, this is her band. Right. She loves this band.
Is it really?
Yeah.
I did not know that.
De La Soul and these guys were my indoctrination into hip hop.
Really. Brandon?
It makes sense.
Yeah. Oh. They're in. I'm a yes.
I like this. All right, here we go. We're going to go down the list here. We're going to talk about this for a minute.
Okay. Wait,
so
should we take a break?
We're going to go through.
Whoa.
We've been doing this for 3 hours.
We're going to go.
I know it feels like that, but this is the best show I've had in a long time. Yes, sorry, Gene. Okay. Yes, Tom Bailey. Sorry, yes.
Okay, we're going to go with a definite 4 votes. Okay. So the 4 votes are Frampton.
Okay.
Lemmy. Lenny.
Lemmy.
Okay. Yeah. Is Lemmy in?
No.
No, I doubt he is.
Motorhead is not in.
Okay, we're going to...
My wife is calling me as this music is playing. That's a sign.
We're going to substitute Lenny with Lemmy.
Good, right.
Okay, so Lenny's in.
Yep.
Oasis.
Uh-huh.
Ozzy. Uh-huh.
Lenny Kravmeister.
And that's the only people that got four.
Wow.
That's so cool. The only three of them?
Okay.
No, four.
Four got unanimous.
But there was some hesitation. So we're going to revisit this. Eric B. and Rakim, you said maybe.
Yeah, but for yeah.
So yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Eric B. and Rakim, you said
wait,
maybe.
Wait, hold on. Mark the four solid. The four yeses.
I have the four yeses right here.
I want to see.
He wants to know they're going to vote.
I want everyone to see that we're actually
voting.
He wants
voting. To know that
we're
actually doing this ballot.
Yeah, all right. So the four were Oasis.
Okay.
Oasis, Frampton.
Yeah. Okay.
Ozzy.
Yes.
Yeah.
Lenny.
Oh,
right. Okay.
Okay. All right. So this is helpful. This is good to see. Okay.
Now we only have three more. Who had three votes?
Yeah. Okay, hold on. Give me the.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. All right. So there was a maybe from Tom for Foreigner.
Mm. Oh, yeah, you
that is now moved to a no.
Okay. Mm.
There's no way.
So
to make it in just because of the numbers.
But there's three of us that said yes. So you. It's
okay.
A yes. Yes.
Hold on.
Three of us said yes.
So there was a maybe from Tom for Eric B. and Rakim, and you said yes. There was a maybe from Eric B. and Rakim for Amit.
Only because I didn't. I wanted to kind of see where we're going, and this is hard because.
Just say
hard.
Yes or no.
Yes or no.
Well, over Foreigner in the Rock Hall of Fame, it's a no.
Okay. Okay. And James, there was a maybe from Tom.
No, you said yes.
No.
I said it was a maybe, and I'm saying like now, just looking that I have three left.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a no.
No. Okay.
Okay,
so let's go with the threes.
Threes.
Are you ready for the threes?
Why are you playing death?
How many threes?
I'm not. It's on a shuffle.
How many threes?
Okay, you ready?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
There's Cher.
Uh-huh.
That's a yes.
Yeah.
There's Foreigner.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's a yes.
There's Janes.
Uh-huh.
There's Kool and the Gang.
That's a yes.
Uh-huh.
Those are the three.
That's four.
That's four.
No. I didn't say yes, Janes.
And there's Tribe Called Quest.
Oh wow. Interesting. So we have five to go threes. To three.
There are three that I'm going to do home alone when
no
one is watching.
You're finishing it tonight. I will live with the consequences.
Please. Amit.
Star Rider is
because I love you. I'm going to let you. I'm going to do the trust exercise. You check that box.
Okay. Hey, baby. Hey, Shayna. Look what I'm doing.
Come on.
Look what I'm doing.
You checked just that one box.
Star Rider. Look at that. I want to know what love is.
I'm just going to fill it all in.
Would you solid show me?
Solid Foreigner.
Solid Foreigner.
Oh, my God, Tommy, you made my fucking
okay,
day.
Okay, so one more on your ballot.
I have one more on my ballot.
Between Cher, who else?
There was Foreigner, Janes, Kool and the Gang, and Tribe.
Tribe Called Quest.
So it's basically between Tribe Called Quest and Cher. On your ballot.
No, he's got one more pick, right?
He picked Tribe Called Quest. Wow.
That's it. Sorry, Sinead.
I think we fucked up by giving Kravitz over Cher.
Look, it's a tough call. It's like Sophie's Choice, right?
You. That was
it. It's like Sophie's Choice. You have to think of all the people Cher hooked up with and all the people that Momoa and Kravitz hooked up
again,
with.
Cher's more important to rock.
We could all agree this was a tough year.
Yeah, it was.
This was a tough year.
But I think we made the right decisions, right?
I think that...
No?
No, I don't like this list that was chosen tonight. That was not my list. I have my list.
Oh my God, fuck. Here we go.
All right,
my list was Cher, Oasis, Ozzy, Frampton, Kool and the Gang, Tribe, and Janes.
Ba-ba-ba, Brando's playing.
But maybe if you had cooler bits... Maybe a killer day.
This might Thursday just be boots. The Thursday Boots
Thursday
talking.
Fox. That's the company. No, but they're not a sponsor. No.
This is going to be a controversial, tough one, no matter which way it comes. Because I think your Cher is going to get in.
I hope so.
I think she's going to get in.
Honestly, I love sharing.
But
Cher
literally,
with the world.
Like you go, like okay.
Here's
Brampton
what I want.
Might not get in.
Here's what I want.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
This,
right.
This is my fantasy. All right.
Should we go to a break and do another hour?
No. We can wrap it up. I want to wrap it up.
Do you have to edit this? Who has to? Who's to be the fool that has to edit this?
No. This is how it goes out. There's no editing.
Oh my God.
Here's the deal. Share.
I'd edit the hell out of this.
Look, it might be a bad
name.
Please
edit this.
It might be a bad name, but here's the world is so divided right now, and I know we didn't pick you, but if the world chooses for you to get into the Rock Hall, I think it's a great time to announce your Russian tour, Chernobyl, and you will bring peace to the world if you do this. So I'm voting for the Chernobyl tour, where we all get to hear, just on repeat, Gypsies, Tramps, and Thieves, over and over and over, to a disco auto-tuned track.
Can I?
Thank you, Cher.
Can I also say, I have a really good Canadian pal named Craig, mm-hmm. who pointed out once that every post Pearl Jam band, if you listen closely, are mm-hmm. only saying the word Cher. Cher.
Yeah.
Cher.
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 All right, this has been another special Rock and Roll Hall of Fame voting edition of Rock Tales. Tom DeSavia, everyone go out and
guys,
buy.
Guys, I love you. I was so, thank you for letting me come play in the clubhouse.
Oh my God, we love you so much. But for real.
Here's your ballot.
If you,
I'll just mail this in.
If you haven't gotten Tom's book, one of many, then you're missing out. This is a good read. Tom, we love seeing you, hanging with you. You're a good friend. We have St. Paddy's Day coming up. Do you guys want to go to Tom Bergen's and have some fish and chips?
1,000%.
Oh, wow.
Let's do an Irish themed bands and, you know, only bands from Ireland.
I love it.
Right, for St. Paddy's Day. Only Irish bands. Thin Lizzy. A Thin Lizzy show we could do. But can we all hold hands again and close this show out?
Yes.
So thank you for a very special episode of Rock Tales. We will see all you mother truckers in the very near future.
Does this look infected?
Bye
to
for
you?
Now.
Yes.
Yeah, that's gross. You touched it. You touched it.
Never had something, but it taught me well with its smooth southern style. 3 months later, I'm a gal in trouble, and I haven't seen him for a while. Oh, I haven't seen him for a while. She was born in the wagon of a traveling